Hi, I'm Pia. I'm an economic researcher and I teach macroeconomics. In this video, we're going to think as economists, more specifically, the role of economists as policy advisors. In order to do so, we're going to start by going over how advice is constructed, that is, positive and normative analysis. Once we went over that, we will see that economists' advice is not always followed, and we're going to see why. And also, we will try to understand why do economists disagree, even though they use the same reasoning process. With this content, you'll be able to interpret how an economist constructs an advice and what roles does it play for the policymaker. So let's begin. In order for economists to provide advice, they had to elaborate an analysis for each given situation. How do they construct this? Economists battle between two types of analysis, positive and normative. Positive statements are claims that attempt to describe the world as it is. For example, GDP annual growth rate in country A decreased from 2% to minus 0.5% in the last year. This is a factual statement, which is based on empirical data and doesn't involve an opinion. This means that positive analysis involves the use of data, which is why positive economics involve the use of the scientific method. The scientific method consists in a structured process that aims to discover how the world operates by testing and verifying hypotheses. For other disciplines, the scientific method usually involves many hours in the lab. However, in economics, there are some things which are impossible to recreate. Economists also aren't allowed to manipulate policy in order to generate data, since that test would actually have an impact on the population. This is why conducting experiments in economics is often impractical. So, how do we apply the scientific method in economics? Assumptions play a key role in the scientific method since they aim to make the complex world more simple and easier to understand. They also allow to isolate the impact of certain variable on another, keeping the other variables fixed. This is known as ceteris paribus. Assumptions are essential to create models, since they become simple. Economic models are tools that help us understand reality, and they use assumptions to be simpler and applicable to other contexts. Positive analysis allows economists to think as scientists. However, this is not the only input. Economists can also be advisors, and in order to exercise that task, empirical data is not everything. Normative statements are claims that aim to manifest how the world should be. For example, comparing to the sentence used for positive analysis, its normative counterpart could be: Country A should restore its path towards economic growth. As you may see, this statement is not based on data. It shows the advisor's point of view and interpretation of a certain event. We can confirm or deny the normative statements through data and views on ethics, religion, and political philosophy. Positive views about how the world works affect normative views about what policies are desirable. So, in order for economists to provide advice, it is likely for them to convey analysis using factual data, as well as their own values. Taking that the process of decision-making involves a scientific method and that the advice is based on evidence, why is it that the economist's advice is not always followed? First of all, economic policy differs from academic statements. What does that mean? It means that what we read from textbooks or when we analyze an economic model, even though they seek to explain reality, they usually omit the actual process of implementing that policy. Public administration involves the functioning of many departments and secretaries that have certain processes in order to get things done. Those may take time, bureaucracy, red tape, which may affect the plans of the policymaker as well as the policy's impact. Also, economists aim to suggest the best policy option according to certain conditions, such as the possibilities of carrying it out, the context, the assessment between trade-offs and possible effects, and their own source of judgment. Taking that into account, they seek to arrive at the best possible scenario. However, that may omit some things that may be harmful for the policymaker. For example, even though some advice may be the best choice possible, it still can affect a certain group of people. A policymaker must consider what portion of the population is affected and also in which way. In addition, the ways of communicating said decision can also be crucial, since public opinion may be affected. Picture this. Would a politician execute a policy next to the elections, knowing that his public image would get worse? Economists may suggest optimum solutions, but they could take too long to be implemented, or the process could be too harmful for certain parts of the population. Finally, policymakers have teams of advisors. However, this can lead to many economists thinking differently and providing different solutions to the same dilemma. This takes us to the next section. Why do economists disagree? Disagreements between economists can be caused by both positive and normative reasons. Disagreements based on positivism occur when economists disagree about the validity of alternative positive theories of how the world works. That is, the pre-existing sources of information may not be the same for everyone, since there may be different conceptions about their relevance. Those debates are often based on the assumptions and variables considered for certain models or hypotheses. Economists may have different values and therefore different normative views about what government policy should aim to accomplish. As we know from our discussion of normative and positive analysis, policies cannot be judged on scientific grounds alone. Sometimes, economists give conflicting advice because they have different values or political philosophies. With everything we just covered, it's time for an exercise that will help us think as economists. Look at the next two sentences. One of them is a positive statement, and the other one is normative. Which one is which? A. In the short run, there is a trade-off between inflation and unemployment. B. The government should implement monetary policy to offset the economic recession. If you think that A is a positive statement and B is normative, then you are correct. The first statement tells us a fact. The fact is that there exists an inverse correlation between inflation and unemployment in the short run. This is actually the Phillips curve. The other statement incorporates values, since it says that the government should only be able to apply monetary policy to control inflation. This is based on monetarism. Now imagine those were your truths. You observe and believe in the short-run trade-off shown by the Phillips curve, and you also believe that inflation should only be controlled using monetary policy. Imagine a country's economy is growing, which is making unemployment to decrease rapidly. You work as an advisor for a politician. Which advice would you give him? Yes, you would advise the implementation of monetary policy. Given that unemployment is decreasing, your positive analysis would lead you to think that inflation will be boosted in the short term. And as your normative analysis is compatible with monetarism, your final advice would be for the government to apply monetary policy to prevent inflation from rising. Which are the most common mistakes? First of all, advice is not only based on opinions. It always has to be supported by evidence. Also, different contexts also lead to different opinions. One economist being right doesn't necessarily mean that everyone who says the opposite is wrong. For example, some models may work on certain countries with certain realities, but if the assumptions and contexts are different in another country, that may not work. This could generate for economists to have opposite opinions, and however, both of them are right. Wrapping up, we've seen in this video that when economists provide advice, they construct their analysis by combining positive and normative analysis. This does not always contemplate the self-interest of every person in the population of the policymakers' position towards the voters. It may also depend on different sets of values or even different assumptions. That is why this advice is not always followed, and it is common for economists to disagree. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and also, if you want to learn more about the topic, feel free to explore and check.